So here's a story for you. Texas moving toward allowing concealed handguns in public college classrooms with a key vote over the weekend. Well, the issue just got a boost from actor Vince Vaughn, the True Detective star telling British GQ about monsters that target schools, saying, quote, "They are looking to slaughter defenseless human beings. They do not want confrontation. In all of our schools, it is illegal to have guns on campus. So again and again, these guys go and shoot up these bleeping schools because they know there are no guns there. They are monsters killing six-year-olds." Joining me now, Marjorie Clifton, former consultant to the Obama campaign and principal Clifton Consulting, and Mercedes Schlapp, GOP strategist and former spokeswoman for President George W. Bush. Great to have the two of you here. Controversial topic here, but now you have Vince Vaughn weighing in a very strong way, saying that he thinks that we should have guns. What do you think, Marjorie?
Well, I'm not sure what expertise Vince Vaughn has on the topic, otherwise playing someone on TV. So I don't give a lot of credibility to Vince Vaughn. Who I do give a lot of credibility is to the chancellor at the University of Texas, General McRaven, four-star general, worked at trying to get Osama bin Laden, was in charge of those raids, and has deeply knows this issue, who said we do not want guns on our college campuses. 4,317 universities across the country, 94% of college students say, we don't want guns on our college campuses, and with good reason. And I think the debate in Texas is an emotional one. We don't want government overreach. I hear all of that. But there's a practical issue, and I think that's what a lot of these universities are speaking to.
Well, it's interesting.
It's
interesting, Mercedes, because about 7 minutes ago, before we went to break, we played a soundbite from a young woman on a college campus who said, look, I'm only 5'3", and if a guy comes up to me and attacks me and I'm not allowed to carry, I have no defense. What do you make of that?
That's right. I mean, it's not only our constitutional right, but this is a woman's issues right. I mean, for what we know of is that women, for the most part, are the most vulnerable for any of these attacks. Whether take the case of Amanda Collins, who was a student in Nevada, and she had a concealed carry permit, but she couldn't bring her firearm onto campus because it was prohibited. Guess what? She was raped at gunpoint by someone who owned a gun illegally. This empowers women. This is what we're seeing right now is you've seen sexual assault and rape cases increase in these campuses. And what we do know is that those campuses that allow for campus carry laws and have campus carry laws, what you have seen is that there has been no spike in violence or firearms incidents.
Okay, I want to go back to another Vince Vaughn quote, no matter what you think about him. Here's what he said. Banning guns is like banning forks in an attempt to stop making people fat. Taking away guns, taking away drugs, the booze, it won't rid the world of criminality. Still don't agree with him, Marjorie?
No, I do agree with that fact, but I will say this. What I disagree with is actually the prevalence of homicides, gun-related homicides on college campuses is very, very low. You're talking about 12,000 homicides a year on average, and only about 10, and it's a very rare incident. And, you know, part of the things that you do have to look at, again, are the statistics. There has been no drop in crime where there have been concealed handguns, so it's not a deterrent proven deterrent.
That's not true, Marjorie.
And I will say, and it is true, and one other thing I will say is I hear you when you talk about the young woman scared of someone grabbing them at night, but what if they were, and it was their buddy, like, you know, when I was a University of Texas student, I can't imagine, you know, the number of over half of college students abuse drugs and alcohol.
I hear that side of it, but I want to get Mercedes back in here because you did not agree with Marjorie's point.
No, 2 points. One is Colorado that has this campus carry law. In fact, what we have seen with campus robberies, with aggravated sexual assaults, those numbers have decreased a third. Okay, so they've had this law since 2003. So again, we go back to the case of the fact that when you look at the bill, let's look at the bill in Texas. We're talking about 21-year-olds. These are responsible 21-year-olds that have these concealed carry permits already.
Okay.
And the fact that they have to leave their gun or firearm before they enter campus is just not right.
All right. We're going to see how this plays out.
I will say,
we're watching it play out in Texas for now. I got to wrap it up. I know we could go on and on this, but Marjorie and Mercedes, thank you very much.